In May of 2010, we flew to Marrakech to climb Jebel Toubkal, the highest peak in the Atlas Mountains that lie to the south of the city. The road from Marrakech to Imlil is challenging, very windy, and subject to flooding and landslides.
You know, the first time I traveled out in the rain and snow, in the rain and snow. You know, the first time I traveled out in the rain and snow, in the rain and snow.
We stayed at the Kashbah Samra, an authentic guest house in the Berber village of Tamaturt, near to Imlil. It had no electricity, wood fires for heat, candles for light, and delicious home-cooked food. Eco-tourism at its best. We did the 2-day climb to the summit without porters, mules or guides. We started from Imlil, a kind of Wild West base camp, and headed for the refuge de Mouflon below Toubkal where we would sleep. We have to climb over 2,400 meters and 21 kilometers in 2 days, and then descend the whole distance in one go. Tough going, especially when you're carrying all your own kit.
From the Mouflon refuge, and I can't believe that we have walked up all of that way today. My feet are absolutely killing me. Ugh. And now I'm going to have a really nice mint tea.
At dawn the next day, we left the Mouflon refuge and followed a thin thread of other climbers up the snow-covered south coombe of Jebel Toubkal. The route was icy and rocky in places, and higher up we encountered long, steep scree slopes. This was our first high altitude climb, and although we were only carrying light packs, every step of 960 meter ascent to the summit was physically demanding.
Morning, I thought, shit, I'm not even sure I can do this. I felt knackered. Oh, as we got going, I felt better and better on the climb. By the time we got to the top of the screw slope, I knew we could do it.
Conditions had been perfect for our summit attempt, and we enjoyed magnificent views over the snow-covered peaks of the Atlas, and could even see the Sahara Desert to the south. The trek back to Imleo was grueling, but a small price to pay for such a memorable achievement. The next leg of our journey took us south, over the Atlas Mountains, to the timeless Kashbars of the Anti-Atlas. The ksar of Aït Benhaddou in the Unila Valley is an outstanding example of a 17th century mud-built fortified city, now preserved as UNESCO World Heritage Site. Leaving Aït Benhaddou, we journeyed further south, towards Wazazert and Merzouga, close to the fringes of the Sahara Desert. Safari close to the Algerian border gave us a flavour of the harsh life of the semi-nomadic Berber people of the area. One of the highlights of our trip was the camel safari into the Sahara, where we spent the night in a Berber tent. Thank you. Dades Valley, with its spectacular gorges, contains some of the finest scenery in Morocco. Here, life is little changed from biblical times. Pearl du Dades is a luxury restored cash bar in the Dades Valley, tastefully furnished in the decor of the Sahel region. The long journey back to Marrakech took us over the Atlas Mountains once more, where we watched the sunset on the final night of our holiday.